a dictatorial regime under falsehood of democracy. Now, when you look at the working exercise, really, who are they process pass? I mean, get passes or permits for working? Because if somebody is working peacefully, why must you obstruct him? If anything, if this gentleman, if any of those people were left to walk free of charge, I don't think there could be any case. I think people are just scared of what they have done and what they seem to be going to do. So I'm so much concerned that our country is going to the dogs. I thank you.
Strong statement. Spectrum, hello? Hello?
Hello, good evening, Spectrum.
Good evening, your name, sir?
Hello?
Your name?
Yes, good evening, Spectrum.
Good evening, sir. Your name?
This is Dale.
Dale, go on.
I very much appreciate your topic this evening. And I have this small comment I want to make in as far as today's demonstration are concerned. What we have seen today have really given us the picture of the quality of the opposition we have in the country. People are hungry for an alternative government, but they are set to get a government that can push their interests to the death. I don't believe that in trying to show that security prices are up, it calls for one to walk on the street while inciting other people to disorganize. The little economic activities other governments are doing. So it is very upset that such a leadership couldn't even hold a dialogue or a conference and address issues concerning affecting Ugandans in the forum and even show them to the public. We have a lot of rights in the network. They would have first captured their issues properly rather than disorganizing even the little economic activities that few people are doing. I also have this to say that I am one of the people who was not happy with total liberalization of the economy. What we are seeing is the result of the pull out of the damage from the economy and leaving it in the hands of the private individual. Ugandans are suffering because they are being overcharged while the government is at the side working. The government is pulled back and come and have the control over the economy. Otherwise, we are still facing a lot of suffering.
All right, Joe, thank you for your succinct contribution. Spectrum, hello? Hello? When you call in, please walk away from your radio or switch it off altogether. Hello?
Hello?
Your name, my friend?
My name is Carol.
Yes, Carol.
And mine is a solution.
Yeah.
I've heard him talk about taxes, and I don't know what honorable that was, but he talked about taxes and said he cannot touch taxes. But in my opinion, taxes like VAT, like in the UK, when they have such a crisis, they usually lower the VAT rate and at such a time as when everything is going back to the normal, they can take it back to where it was. But in Uganda, it's 18% ever since it was put into existence. It's been 18% and that's it. So if the government can look at that tax, maybe they could reduce that. As and when things are back to normal, they can hike it. That's it.
All right, Carol, thank you. Spectrum, hello? Hello? You're live on air, please switch off your radio or walk some distance from me. Hello?
Hello?
Yes, your name?
Hello?
Your name, sir?
Isha Oto is my name.
Come again, Isha Oto, Honorable Isha, you're welcome.
Fine, thank you. I salute the two gentlemen in the studio and all of us, the listeners. First, I want to start by condemning what I saw today, the terror which was being unleashed on innocent civilians of Uganda who are walking patiently, innocently, to report to their places and offices of work. I do not see any reason why the police would go ahead to arrest any citizen of Uganda who is walking from his home to his workplace. Why couldn't they arrest the rest of these other ordinary civilians who were walking going to their offices? Why were they targeting particular individuals, like Besigye, like Mao, and the rest. These are Ugandan citizens. They have the right to walk, to move, to talk, to enjoy fundamental rights and freedom, which is inherent. It can never be granted by Museveni and Kale Kaihura. Unless the government is now saying people should get working permit. By tomorrow, they should start issuing working permit to each individual Ugandan. So that as you walk on the road, you show your permit to Museveni and Kale Kaihura. Uganda has gone through difficult times. When some of us were being born in the bushes, we grew up seeing people struggling with pain and suffering. We have reached a level where we needed to settle and handle issues as required by the laws of the land. But it is really very, very backward and ignorant to find today Ugandan government not even able to understand what we call inherent rights, which is not granted by anybody. And what I saw today, really, it is very unfortunate. Because how would you get me on the road, walking to my office, and then you arrest me?
Doctor, Member of Parliament for Yam South, Nia Lira, thank you very much. Indeed. Spectrum, hello.
Hello.
Your name?
My name is Jen.
Yes, Jen.
Hello?
You're live on air, Jane. Please go on.
Hello?
You're live on air. Please go ahead with your question or comment.
Yes, yes. What I wanted to say is that running the country is like running the home. And for instance, for example, in the house, when there's a shortage, when there's a crisis, what we do is you begin to prioritize. And if you've been preparing meat or if you've been preparing chicken, then you turn to ginat or beans. But it's unfortunate that our leaders cannot get to a level where we begin prioritizing. If we were interested in the citizens, if they have us at heart as people who voted them into power, these are some of the things that they should be doing. And for example, there's no reason why we should. How many times have we had President Museveni swearing in? And who would not understand if, for example, the 3 billion square diverted to saving the lives of people? We are fighting, we are struggling to make sure that people survive another day, but our leaders cannot see that. And therefore, for me, I think the work to work is really timely, and it is just a matter of time. One may think that this was it didn't achieve the results that it was intended to, but from my perspective, as a common person, I think the point has been driven home. That, you know, we cannot continue seeing the situation, the conditions that we are going in happening. That, you know, we are yet to get to rise.